established that all criminal suspects must be advised of their rights before being interrogated. Ernesto Miranda was the subject of the case. The courts found that his rights had been violated. A false confession was obtained. On August 1st, Charles Whitman climbed to the top of a tower at the University of Texas in Austin and shot and killed 13 people and wounded another 31. Prior to the sniper killings, Whitman had already killed his wife and mother in order to save them from the embarrassment of what was to come. Austin police officers were finally able to end the shooting spree after 96 minutes when they shot and killed Whitman. Groundbreaking for the World Trade Center in New York City took place on August 5th. The demolition of 13 square blocks of what was called Radio Row made way for the Twin Towers, along with 5 additional buildings in the complex. September 5th, Jerry Lewis held his first muscular dystrophy Labor Day telethon. The event lasted 21 and a half hours and raised over $1 million for the Muscular Dystrophy Association. On September 8th, Star Trek first premiered on NBC. The science fiction television series was created by Gene Roddenberry and followed the adventures of the Starship Enterprise and its crew, including Captain Kirk, played by William Shatner, and Spock, played by Leonard Nimoy. September 29th brought us the first Chevrolet Camaro, which was originally named the Panther. The Camaro was Chevy's response to the Ford Mustang and is considered one of the most perfectly designed cars that ever came out of General Motors. Prototype of the automated teller machine, otherwise known as an ATM, was displayed for the first time on October 25th. The American Bankers Association's annual meeting was being held in San Francisco, and the new banking machine touted as the Bank of 27. It's The Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown, premiered on CBS. In the special, Linus eagerly waits in a pumpkin patch on Halloween night for the arrival of the Great Pumpkin, which he believes delivers toys to children. The Great Pumpkin delivered a 31.6 Nielsen rating, making it the 30th highest rated telecast of 1966. On November 8th, film and television actor Ronald Reagan was elected governor of California. Reagan, a Republican, was able to mobilize conservative voters to defeat incumbent Governor Pat Brown in a landslide. On December 15th, Walt Disney died while producing the animated feature The Jungle Book. Disney, who was a heavy smoker, died at the age of 65 after being diagnosed with lung cancer a month earlier. His brother Roy would pick up the reins, go on to complete the work of opening Walt Disney World a few years later. Finally, on December 18th, Howl the Grinch Stole Christmas, which was narrated by Boris Karloff, aired for the first time on CBS. The Dr. Seuss classic was perfectly animated for television by Chuck Jones. It would go on to become a holiday tradition.